This is something I hate talking about, but let's do this. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And this video is going to be a little bit different, hopefully the same, I don't know. But the style, the tone of it might be a little bit off. This is where I get a little rambly. Maybe it's because of nervousness, maybe fear. By the end of it, I hope you don't think I'm a lunatic and say, what does this guy know about mental health? But I don't know, maybe some of you can relate to this. But yeah, we're gonna be talking about body positivity, and I'm gonna talk about the issues with my weight, because I don't know if you got the memo, but I am a little bit on the chunky side, all right? But yeah. So when it comes to mental health, okay, weight, body image, all those things have a lot to do with our mental health. So just a little bit about my struggles with my weight. When I was younger, when I was like a kid growing up, I was never a big kid, you know? Like, I was a bigger kid, but I was not like I am now, if you will. Anyways, I got into sports at a young age and things like that, but as I got older, middle school and high school, I was constantly comparing myself to other people, and that's a lot of when we start developing these types of behaviors. We start judging ourselves and start, you know, for me personally, I started just wondering, like, why can't I just look like that guy over there? Why can't I have a body like that guy? And, you know, throughout even high school, I was doing football, wrestling, track, I was always in sports, I was eating right, eating healthy, and there's something with my body where I can have like one little sugary treat and like I explode. Meanwhile, my best friend, he can sit down and eat like 10 cheeseburgers and still have like the body of a Greek god. You know what I mean? And I used to be very resentful for that. Like, I didn't like to accept the fact that I can't eat whatever I want. I cannot, you know, look like that unless I put in a ton of work. And even when I'm putting in a ton of work, exercise, eating healthy, I still don't have my ideal physique. So, you know, for the most part, even though I thought I was fat in high school, like, for the most part, you know, part of me being healthy was purely based on the fact that I wanted to look good and I cared what people thought about me. I wanted to attract a certain type of woman, and I didn't think I could if I was overweight. So to the best of my ability, I was managing my weight. Now, fast forward, and I will spare you this part of the story. If you would like, check out the info card up there. A lot of this weight was put on in my drug addiction and alcoholism. It's when I completely just stopped caring. You know what I mean? Like 200 pounds of this, if not more, all happened through my active addiction, just so you know. And, you know, it's one of those things, like, have you ever, like, sat back and thought, like, you know, like, I thought I was fat in high school, and I wish I had a time machine to go back in time, find myself talking negatively to myself about my weight, and just slap the living hell out of myself, and be like, that's not fat, this is fat, right? But anyways, when I got clean and I started to focus on my mental health, and something I had to do was I had to learn how to love myself. And a lot of the way I learned how to love myself was by people loving me in a way that I couldn't love myself. And this is where the body positivity talk comes in. And I really wanna make it clear that with this video, I'm talking from my personal experience. I'm sure other people, you know, who are body positive are gonna come across this, and I wanna make it very, very clear that this is my personal experience, nothing negative about anybody else. But what ended up happening was, during this time, I learned how to love myself. And in turn, in learning how to love myself, I stopped caring about my physical health. And that, for me, was one of the downsides of being body positive. It's like, learning how to love me and the weight I am and just feeling myself, you know, and I was dating girls and, you know, all this other stuff. Like, I again stopped caring about my physical health. So for about 5 years, like, I was just eating and doing whatever I wanted. I didn't really exercise or anything like that, because I would justify it by saying, I love myself, this is okay. And for me, that's when being body positive, you know, wasn't a good thing. Because if I look at the reality of the situation, you know, especially when I got clean from drugs and alcohol, like, Why did I do it? Like, there's a multitude of reasons why. One of them is that my life was a freaking mess. But one of them is I wanna be a father to my son. So if I wanna be a father to my son, yeah, I can get rid of drugs and alcohol, but when I'm going to the doctor and they're talking about cholesterol and high blood pressure, unhealthy weights, I actually, when I got clean, I had congestive heart failure, so I already have a weak heart, you know, and my heart is healed a lot, but you know, I'm putting my heart at risk because of my weight. So for me, I have to balance that whole thing of being body positive and loving myself for who I am, but also recognizing that it could be detrimental to my health. And it's twisted and it's crazy because this, as much as I promote positive mental health and I help all you guys out there with depression, anxiety, and all these other things, like this is where my mental health is still a work in progress. Like, for example, I've been beating myself up lately about my weight, and something I often tell people, and by the way, this is a good way to deal with bullies or, you know, whatever, whatever you're dealing with, you know, people at work, whatever it is. Like, I always remember just saying this to myself and saying this to other people, like, no matter what you say to me, no matter how much you beat me up with your words, like, I'm doing a much worse job up here. Like, I can beat myself up like nobody else can. You know what I mean? I can be my own worst enemy. But anyway, I was having a conversation with my friend and I was kind of just like, ugh. You know, just those days when you just like realize how how overweight you really are, and like I was just venting to her and she said this. And by the way, it's interesting because this is a friend who I was talking to about her depression, and then she ends up starting helping me with, you know, me being more positive about my weight and stuff. But anyways, I was telling her about how much weight I've put back on since my weight loss journey last year. And she says, hey man, you have a girl who thinks you're sexy. And you're a real person, just let it motivate you. And you know, and like, I love that, but like, for me, it's a dangerous slippery slope because I take these kind words and my brain can run with them. Like, I have a beautiful, amazing girlfriend who loves me unconditionally, and that can fuel my excuses for not focusing on my weight. Like, some of us do that when we get into a relationship, we start caring about our physical appearance, if you will. But like, I guess the point I'm trying to get at is like, it's so much more than just our physical appearance. It's also the damage I might be doing to my body. And like, you know, I have to figure out a way to break free of that, and I have in the past. So one of the reasons I'm making this video, not only to talk about body positivity and how it can personally be my downfall, is because I, now that I have this platform of YouTube and I have almost 2,000 subscribers now, I feel like I need to be held accountable. And by the way, there's a great way to stay accountable, say things very publicly. And I need to start focusing on my weight again. Like, it's a very real thing. I have a whole playlist called Losing Weight Mindfully. And like, if you look at those videos compared to now, I have put a lot of weight back on. And it's because I fell off. I fell off. It's almost like a relapse when it comes to drugs and alcohol. And this relapse, if you will, happened at Thanksgiving. So that was, I don't know, 5 months ago, you know, I was like, I'm just gonna take a little break for Thanksgiving. And then that turned into, I'm gonna take a little bit of a break for Christmas, you know, when all the goodies are out and all that kind of stuff. And that break has lasted until now we're in the middle of March. So I'm personally getting back on the right track. I have a Fitbit that I haven't been wearing that I'm gonna start using again. I've been talking to some friends. The Fitbit's a great way that I'm able to stay accountable, this video. But also, I'm going to rejoin a program. Some of you have heard me talk about Dr. Judson Brewer. He has one for weight loss. It's called Eat Right Now. And by the way, this is not sponsored in any way. This video is so not sponsored by this app that I'm actually paying full price for it. But when I did this program, like, one of the things about losing weight is I hate everybody's opinions on it. They're like, oh, you gotta do like low carbs and high fats or ketotonic and, you know, fasting. And like, there's just a million different opinions on how to lose weight. And like, this was the first program I did where it was nothing like that. It was all centered around mindfulness. I've mentioned about his programs in the Unwinding Anxiety app, but I managed to lose over 50 pounds last year using this, and then I got to a point where I was like, oh, I'm fixed, I don't need to do this anymore. And like, I'll be honest with you, I've been afraid to go back on the scale in months because I'm afraid to see how much weight I've put back on, and I'm even more afraid that I might've put on even more weight than what I started with. So, as of tomorrow, I'm getting back into that program. And if any of you are interested, I'm gonna put a link to Eat Right Now in the description below. It's cool, it uses mindfulness. It's not like telling you what to eat, it's just having you be more mindful of what you're eating, when you're eating, you know, just really being mindful. Like, it doesn't even suggest that you change your diet at all. It's really cool. And then the biggest part that benefits me is every single week they have like a group video chat where I get to sit and talk about the struggles I've had with other people going through the same thing. You know what I mean? So if any of you are interested, like, I'll put a link in the description. I'd love to see you in one of the weekly video chats that they do. But anyways, I'll try to keep you all posted about my weight loss. And if you want, like, keep me accountable. Comment randomly on my videos, just randomly on my videos, and just say, how's the weight loss going, Chris? Just say that. That really helps me a lot, believe it or not, because I'm like, oh, dang it, I made myself accountable to other people. But reach out to me, see how it's going. Hopefully you'll see the change in this face right here. But yeah, so I'm gonna get back started on tomorrow, and like, I need to, you know, recognize that body positivity can be a bad thing for me personally. But I don't know. If you like this video, like if you think it might be able to help others, I don't know how you guys are gonna react to this video, but feel free to share it. Feel free to share it with people that you know who might be struggling with their weight. My main goal is to live as long as possible, knowing that I'm not in control of a lot of things, but one thing I am definitely in control of is the way I treat my body. You know what I mean? So I wanna be able to be there for my son. I wanna be able to play sports with my son. I wanna be able to go hiking, you know, with my girlfriend, you know, my son, my friends and stuff like that. So that's one of the main reasons why I'm doing this. But anyways, like I said, share this video if you think it'll help somebody. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, my videos are usually a lot more centered around mental health. This one kinda was, but hit the little round subscribe button. If you wanna check out some other videos on this channel, click or tap on one of those thumbnails right there. And thank you so much for watching. Keep me accountable, and I'll see you next time.